Students, now we are continuing with the logarithmic differentiation. In the logarithmic differentiations, we have already studied the formula a raised to power x. A raised to power x is always equal to a raised to power x into log of a. So that will be applying on some questions, and that question is 10 then whole raised to power 10 of x. So we are doing the derivative of that. That will be taking y is equal to 10 of x. So differentiating both sides, when we are applying derivative on it, it becomes y the derivative dy by dx is equal to dy by dx on 10 raised to power x. So this is, in this case, this is our power and this is our base, this is a. So according to this rule, it will be changing into 10 a raised to power x. X is 10 raised to power 10x into log of a. What is a? Log of 10 into the derivative of this part. The derivative of this part is dy by dx of 10 raised to power x, because the power is in triple form. So this is 10 raised to power x. So we are again differentiating this. This is 10 raised to power x into log of 10 into again the derivative of 10 raised to power x. 10 raised to power x will be a raised to power x, means 10 raised to power x into log of 10. So this is a expression for this. Log of 10 will be coming 2 times, and it becomes 10 into 10 raised to power x into 10 raised to power x into log of 10 whole square. This is a scalic form of this we will obtain now. Now the next question which are related to the logarithmic differentiation, that is log cos x and sin of x. So what will you do in that type of question? This question is resembled to one of the logarithmic formula, that is log m or log n. What's that rule, log m or n? So what will you do here? N is lying in base and m is in power form, so that will be equal to natural logarithm of m over natural logarithm of n. So in this way we will change this m or n formula. So this expression will be changing according to formula, that is log of e of cos x or over log of e of sin x. This will be changing into this form, and this is taking equal to y. Now differentiating both sides, when we are differentiating, it becomes dy by dx, or this is dy by dx on what? This is log of cos x over log of sin x. So which rule is applying? That is u by v rule is applying there. So derivative of dy by dx on u by v. The u by v rule says that v is taking constant, dy by dx of u function minus u is taking constant, dy by dx of v function also, or over v square. This expression is coming to know. So it will be changing log of sin x. So log of sin x into dy by dx of log of cos x minus log of cos x second time constant, and dy by dx of log of sin x. So this will be changing log of sin x into log of cos x. What is log of cos x? Cos x will be changing 1 by cos x according to log x rule. Log x rule says that derivative of log x is dy by df of this. This is 1 over x. So it becomes 1 over cos x, and again the derivative of cos x minus log of cos x into derivative of this is again 1 upon sin x, and derivative of dy by dx of sin x. So this rule is applying there. Now it becomes log of sin x into 1 upon cos x. The derivative of cos x is minus sin x, minus log of cos x into 1 upon sin x, or this derivative sin x is cos x. This expression is coming. Now it will be changing log of sin x. This is sin over cos. This is minus of cot x minus. This is again log of cos x. Cos by sin. Again this is this. Firstly this is sin over cos. Sin over cos is tan. This is tan of x. Or this is cos over sin. So cos over sin is cot of x. So this is the expression which are coming to us. Or when we are applying this rule, we are taking the denominator. Denominator is log of sin x whole square. So this is the term which we are left here. This is log of sin x whole square. Or here is also log of sin x whole square, and here is also log of sin x whole square. This is the answer for that expression. Now the another question is related to logarithmic function is dy by dx of log of sin in bracket under root x square plus 1. So what will you do? Again this function, this is function is considering as x, sole function is considering as x. So we are using dy by dx of log x. So dy by dx of log x is 1 over x. So this expression becomes 1 upon sin under root x square plus 1. And here is dy by dx of what? Sin under root x square plus 1. Or in the next step, this is 1 upon sin under root x square plus 1. Then into the derivative of sin is cos. Cos under root x square plus 1. And the derivative of this one function also, this is under root x square plus 1. Then this expression will be changing 1 upon sin under root x square plus 1 into cos under root x square plus 1. So derivative of this is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is coming here. Then it becomes x square plus 1, 1 by 2 minus 1 into dy by dx of x square plus 1. Each and every step can be differentiating. यहाँ पे हर step को differentiate करना है आपने. तो sin under root x square plus 1 into cos under root x square plus 1 into 1 by 2 x square plus 1. 1 by 2 minus 1 is minus 1 by 2. So the derivative of x square is 2x and the derivative of 1 is 0. So this 2 will be cancelled out with this 2 and it becomes 1 upon sin under root x square plus 1, or this is cos under root x square plus 1. Then into x square plus 1 raised to power minus 1 by 2. So this is cos over sin. Cos over sin both are same. This becomes changing into cot. This is cot of under root x square plus 1 into here is x square plus 1 whole power minus 1 by 2. And this x is also left. This is x. So this x is coming here. And this expression becomes x cot under root x square plus 1 this negative power will be changing into positive, it becomes goes to the air and it is under root x square plus 1. So this is the answer for that question. So this type of question, how we can solve, you can see it carefully. These questions are very, very important questions.